We've all been there. Waiting for a web page to load or a process to complete can sometimes feel like a very long time. Skeleton screens, progress bars, and spinners are all ways to show that the system is loading information. I'm going to share the primary purpose of each loading indicator and discuss when to use each. Skeleton screens are wire-like visuals that mimic the layout of the page and are used to indicate that a page is loading. Sometimes these come in the form of static images or animations. Here you can see LinkedIn uses a static skeleton screen as the page loads, which brings me to the point that these are best used for full page loads. You also only want to use skeleton screens when the page load time falls between 2 to 10 seconds. Spinners or wait animations have similar characteristics to skeleton screens. For example, these don't give any indication of how long you'll be waiting. Spinners or wait animations are isolated elements that repeat the same motion. These are best used on a single module, like a video or a card on a dashboard. Here's an example of one. For each card on the dashboard, we see a spinner while the data is being loaded. This works well in this case because we are able to see the general structure of the page, but the spinners on each card provide a strong indication that the data is being loaded. You should only use spinners or wait animations if the wait is under 10 seconds, just like skeleton screens. Now, how do you choose between skeleton screens and spinners? The main advantage of skeleton screens is that they reduce cognitive load for users, avoiding the overwhelming experience of displaying a blank page followed by a full page of content. It also creates an illusion of shorter waiting times and that the page is gradually transitioning into its final format because it looks like a wireframe. Spinners, on the other hand, don't have the same capabilities, and that's why they're better for isolated elements of your web page rather than the whole page. Now, progress bars are quite different from skeleton screens and spinners. Progress bars shows you the progression of a computer operation, like a file uploading, or you're downloading something. These are best used for process-related indicators. Progress bars are strongly recommended for any page that takes longer than 10 seconds to load, because they give users a sense of how much longer they have to wait. At the end of the day, nobody likes to wait. The key thing to consider is, how do we ensure our users stay informed and engaged during these loading times so that they have a seamless experience? Understanding the difference between a skeleton screen, spinner, or wait animation and progress bar will help you ensure that's possible.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.